Each new year takes on a life of its own. 2013 happens to be the year of the snake, according to the Chinese zodiac. And here to tell us a little bit more about what that may mean for the coming year is Reverend Mother Susan from Mother Mystic Spiritual Apothecary. Good morning.
Good morning. Thank you for having me.
Pleasure to have you on. Now, the year of the snake. Everyone's always looking forward to the new year and new beginnings. What can we expect out of this year?
Well, it's not just the year of the snake, it's the year of the water snake. In Chinese astrology, there are five elements and they repeat in a pattern every 60 years. So the last time water snakes were born was 1953. Mm-hmm. So the water snakes are alive today are now turning 60, and parents should need to be aware, anyone who's expecting a child this year, there's certain behavior patterns that are predominant in water snakes. Snakes are very charming people, and the water snakes are especially charming. They will be very persuasive people. Mm-hmm. They are people who get what they want. They are also people who are commitment oriented. If you give them a task to do, they will stay on that task until it's completed. Bear in mind, though, that they love beauty. They love luxury. Mm-hmm. And if you see your persuasive little water snake working for their own benefit way too much, you may want to curb that behavior a little bit. As far as people in general, if you want to tap into that water snake energy, it's a powerful transformation energy. Mm-hmm. I would suggest using ice blue in your home or in your surroundings or in your wardrobe.
Maybe paint a new wall.
Yeah, or just get a ice blue crystal.
Okay.
Pop it in the corner.
Mm-hmm.
It's definitely a year of transformation. It's also look for the details, because things are not always what they seem. Remember, there's that power of persuasion.
Mm-hmm.
Snakes charm.
Ooh, that's true. Yeah, you're right. So you're going to have to dig a little deeper sometimes throughout the year. And it's nice to know you give some advice for those parents, too. Keep kids grounded, even though they will be determined. How about some other things that you actually do at your apothecary? I know tarot card readings, are very popular. Why would people want to get those done for the beginning of the year?
A lot of people want to get some insight as to what's coming for the year ahead for them. Mm-hmm. And they want to plan accordingly. Some people, if they're thinking of jump-starting their career, in a different direction. Is this the year to go for it and how to go about it? Or if people are thinking of making a big change in their lifestyle, what opposition am I going to encounter, or how is it going to go? And romance for the single people, you know, am I going to meet the one this year?
Maybe 2013 has some luck to it. In addition, you also do Reiki treatment. So how are those beneficial for people?
Reiki is a complementary medicine. It comes from Japan, and it works as a relaxation therapy. Okay. And it's especially beneficial for people who are going through, I'd say, traumatic health issues. Mm-hmm. Because it can help the body to relax and let the regular medicine work.
All right, so a little under the weather, or maybe you're feeling a bit stressed, we'll have to turn to you. Thank you so much for coming
in. Thank you.
Plenty to look forward to for the new year. If you want more information on Mother Mystic, head to WPRI.com and click on the Rhode Show.